Good evening and a very warm welcome to the Grassroots Weekender Show. I'm back, I'm Mal Lee. Hope everyone's keeping well out there. And whatever your team's doing in the FA Cup, I hope they're winning for you. Because I know mine isn't. Nathan, when the last time I looked, it was West Ham 2, Doncaster Rovers 0. Oh no, there's another one out of the FA Cup. Dear me. Anyway, I don't know the final score. I might be somewhat surprised. I doubt it very much. But Nathan, thanks for the bull show and thanks for the bull fight. And I'm sure Doncaster tried everything in their power to go through. Well, it's our turn tomorrow against Manchester United. And as they say, it's the lull before the storm. Someone put a post up on social media yesterday. It's very quiet in Scouseland. And I think we know where that's coming from, don't we? But it can't last forever. Folks, we know that Liverpool will bounce back. I'm a Red and I'm a Liverpool supporter through and through. So I'm confident that we can lift our game. If we go out, we go out. There's always next week, isn't there? And that's the way you've got to look at football. It's not a matter of life or death. That's what Bill Shankly said it is. But hey-ho, no, it's lockdown, more important. And at the end of the day, if we don't do anything this season, there's always next season. That's the way to look forward. But I think we'll do something this season. Because Manchester United, you're in for a fight and a half tomorrow. Mark my words. I'm sure I said that the other night anyway. Maybe we can get picked up on that. Anyway, welcome to the show. There is no grassroots football. We know that because we're still in lockdown. So unfortunately, we have to get on with a little bit of banter from ourselves and talk about what might be, which might be that we're back in March with grassroots football. Many of us are telling me they reckon or they concede that the season is opening over in grassroots football. I'm not too sure. We'll get some games in somewhere along the line and we're hoping that the kids can have some fun. And they're going to have some fun with our youth project, welcoming all from Don't Cross the Line. Excuse me, I had a digestive biscuit just before I come on here. Tea and me, worst thing I could have done because I've got no tea to wash it down, to make myself a cup. Anyway, we're looking forward to it. There's loads and loads of celebrities and Paul Cooper, you may have seen him, can't thank him enough for coming onto the show. Well, not coming onto the show, but to be interviewed. And we're hoping somewhere along the line, you know, Paul Cooper, This Country, do you ever see that? Star of the show. Yes, what a guy. And also we're looking forward, hopefully, to getting Charlie and Daisy. We can't commit to that one. We know we've got Paul, who's a superstar, and he's been on Gogglebox 2 with Daisy. So we're looking forward to getting interviews for the kids on that. They're not half lining up, these celebrities, I assure you, kids. So we're looking for a few more kids to get involved, between 11 and 14 years of age. Drop me a line, mal@don'ttakethelion.com. Add me as a friend on Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, all the social network sites. Now you watch my Instagram page, excuse me, start changing with Don't Cross the Line, DXTL TV, we're souping it up. And I'm happy to say that I had a lovely, lovely meeting with a lovely person, young Shannon today. Shannon Baines. I am over Baines, should I say? Oh my God, she'll kill me. Anyway, I'm sorry, Shannon, I really am. On board, and she's going to be our media specialist with Don't Cross the Line. Yes, she joined Team DXTL, and I'm looking forward to a lot of changes coming in here. And she's also going to help us on our Welcoming All project for the youth project. I can't wait. Anyway, really into the photography, really into the media, and we're going to be doing there's all kinds of going on to be. Let me just have a quick look, quick glance on here. And we're going for interview skills for the kids. That's what Shannon's going to be doing. Looking forward to that one. Can't wait to get it on board. We'll be meeting up sometime in the future, as we say, because of lockdown, COVID, social distancing. It's all about that. And that's what we're really into. But hey-ho, welcome aboard to Team DXTL, Shannon Baines. I'm looking forward to working closely with her, and I'm sure the lads will as well. What a difference it's going to make to our photography, to our media productions, for our interviewing skills. Kids, you're going to love it. I'm over the moon, so you'll be over the moon as well. Now then, you may have seen a post that I put up on social media regarding a football shirt, should I say, a referee shirt. Now, when I put it up there, I've got a lot of feedback, people that are interested in it, no doubt they are. So, cast your mind back, we've already held this shirt up. You may have seen that one with the Premier League signatures. Sorry, it's on the floor, but there you go, folks. Loads of signatures on that one. Air Asia, sponsors. And we've also got our friend Chris Foy, who signed on that. Chris, ex-Premier League referee. Let's just put that nice and neat on there. Then we also had this one sent from the PGOML. Thank you very, very much. Up to date. Look at it. Signed. There you go. Brand new. Top of the range. These are going to be framed, by the way. Let me just hold that up for you. Makes it a little bit different, doesn't it? So you can see towards the camera. Wow, what a share to have for grassroots football. And these are going to our raffles for the Run for Emily. Raffles or auctions, I'm not too sure. People are offering me money already for the shirts. So it remains to be seen what we're gonna do with them. I don't know yet. When they're framed, we'll make our minds up. And if you've got any ideas there, please let us know. And we know that people are screaming for an auction and being offered loads of money. I think it went up to 150 or something. And people are just, this without it being framed, Jamie, what's it going to go up to in the long run? I'll let you know, and you can let me know what you'd prepare to pay for that if we did auction it. And this is going to be the new shirt for running. Now, you've seen this one. And obviously, this is magical. This is what we're going to be wearing when we're training, and also hopefully doing our run for Emily on the 28th of March. And we've got on there Emily's Leap of Faith, and we have the GoFundMe logo on there. So if you want to donate, please donate. And obviously auction, raffles, we've got loads and loads of prizes, more coming. We're not doing it until everything's in, then we can do one big prize, because I don't want to do a raffle and not have anything in. Promise you, you know where I'm coming from. So that, I hope you like our t-shirts. Don't cross the line supporting it. Team DXTL doing the run as well. So I'll put that with the Premier League shirts. We've got a shirt from Milner as well. Got an Everton signed shirt as well. So, wow, it's coming in. We've got Premier League ball. We've got plenty of stuff. Really, really is. It's going to be a top of the range raffle or auctions. It all depends. If we can raise, someone wants to offer me £25,000 for a lot, I'll accept it now. Go on. We won't even bother raffling. 25,000 for the Premier League shirt, Everton signed shirt, Liverpool shirt, Premier League ball. My God, there's loads of stuff. Others goodies, there's even a jar of sweets. Isn't it, Tony? We've got everything there. 25 grand. If you've got the 25,000, it's safe. Well, we still do the run because it's a run for Emily. That's the funding that we need to raise for Emily. So come on, work together. And it saves us doing a raffle then. And do you know what? The publicity you will get. £25,000, that's all we're asking for, just to help out Emily. Cerebral palsy she suffers from, and she needs a pain-free operation. And that's what we're doing, to raise the funds for it. And honestly, you can have all them, and we'll even get them framed for you, I assure you. So they'll be worth a few bob. You'll get some of the money back, if not plenty of the money back. £25,000, can you help us on the way? That's our appeal. And we'll give you all the memorabilia that we've got. And as I say, it's a lot, and it's worth a fortune. There's a Liverpool and Everton ball there as well. It's, what more could you ask for? If you've got the money, spare us doing the auction and the raffle, please, and help us out. That's our appeal. Doubt it, we'll get it, but you never know. If you don't ask, you don't get. Anyway, we're talking about grassroots football, aren't we? What grassroots football? It's FA Cup weekend, and as I say, let's hope your team are doing well, or the successful in what they're doing. If not, commiserations. As I say, there's always next year. It's only a game of football. More than that, to many passionate fans out there, we know that. We all like our teams to win. And we want grassroots football back so our referees can get out there, keep themselves fit, because they must be chomping at the bit at the moment with their referee kits. How many have lost them already? How many have put them away in the draw? Don't expect any games for a while. Got to be quite a few here, and you may as well start ordering your new ones now if you can't find them. Where did I put that shirt? Where did I put that whistle? How many whistles are going to be lost? Got to be quite a few referees, hasn't it? You've got to be misplacing that somewhere. Anyway, good luck to all of you. Don't forget to polish your boots. Get them all ready. You'll be out there before you know it, I'm sure. And anyway, look at this terrible weather. I bet we're all glad that we're not playing football. and refereeing at the moment, but that's what we expect. It is a winter sport, really, isn't it? Grassroots football. We all get used to it. We all get full of colds. So, looking forward to, well, March, when it's all going to be back, but they are calling to extend it now into summer. I really don't know. I just hope it does come back, because we don't want to see teams folding. We don't want to see teams struggling. We want to see you all coming through with great football intentions. And that means warming your hands up in the cold weather by clapping, encouragement, supporting our referees, respect. And look, we've even got the waving to tell you that. This is it. Do not cross the line. Don't cross the line. It's called respect. That will be going back out, I assure you, in March when the games do start up. And there's our new logo, in case you're wondering what's happening. We're just getting you used to that. Don't cross the line. You'll see that on many of the shirts. You saw that before on Emily's shirt, a Run for Emily. And that's what we'll be publicising as well on all our gear. Our branded gear, should we say, because there's a lot of it coming. And as I say, all the team will be going to be wearing that, especially in our run. We're looking forward to it. But in the meantime, we're talking about teams folding. Now, that could be a sore point somewhere along the line. Are the teams still out practicing? The kids doing individual training? We see it all over social media. We see plenty of it where the kids are training on their own. Still got a smile on their face, keeping the ball practice up. I'm not too sure whether the sports shops are getting inundated with new orders. But look at me in the studio yet again on my own. And I got a massive mention off Tony Mann for giving us a mention yesterday. And also, I've got to give a mention to Gordon Johnson. So you can get the, you can swap autographs, actually. You're both having a go at each other. Gordon asked for Tony's autograph and Tony wanted to charge. So we'll mention Gordon. The two of them can be at it and ask for each other's autographs. So there you go, got a mention. And a massive happy birthday to Colin Fulton as well. Colin, top man, does loads for charity, loads for grassroots football, runs teams left, right and centre. It was Colin's birthday a couple of days ago. So, well done, Col. You've got a mention as well there, mate. But you'll always get the mention for the good things that you do within grassroots football. Social media has come to life. People trying to raise funding for everything, even us, as I say. So, we've asked for £25,000. Not much, is it? Especially if you've got the money. And if I win the lottery, I didn't win it last night. But I'm looking forward to winning it tonight. I haven't even checked my horses today. I've done one or two bets. So, I might be quids in there, and I might just be able to donate the money myself if I win the lottery this evening. So you never know. Watch this space. Then I've got to put it on first, though. As soon as the show's finished, I'll pop your lottery on. And oh no, I done it last night. I made sure I'd done two of them so I didn't miss out in case I was running late today, which I am. Anyway, what are you up to during the lockdown? Are you enjoying yourselves? Are you celebrating your birthdays at home? And I think I've got a special mention tomorrow for someone's birthday as well. So what's this space? I think someone's 40th tomorrow, if I'm right. Well-known person in grassroots football, so be giving a mention out there as well. So what are you up to? Referees, we just mentioned whether you misplaced the whistle, you've got all your gear ready just in case you get the call up and we get talked about and someone says, do you know what, let's end this lockdown in 2 weeks. Everything's honky-dory. Doesn't look like it at the moment, but you never know. Be ready, be on call, be raring to go. I'm sure the teams are raring to go already. How many boots have been used? The brand new spanking pair of boots, the new kits that were bought for Christmas for the teams. Everyone raring to put them on. Managers raring to go with their new boots. I don't know what is happening. So give us some information, some feedback, what you're up to, what training skills you're doing, how are you keeping the kids in contact? I know many of them social media and putting up ball skills for them. Coaches are all out there very, very busy trying to keep the kids active and alive, but it's going to be very, very hard. And a big mention to Pab Rutherford, by the way, and Kath. Apparently they've been struck down with COVID. They're not very happy, they're not very well. So I just wish them all the very, very best as well. Please get well soon, because we'll miss you in grassroots football if you're not there. And they give a really powerful message out this morning to be really safe. Take care out there, because COVID-19 is out there and they don't want to be sharing it with anyone else. They're staying in and they want you to be safe as well. So we wish them all the very, very best indeed. So if you're struck down with it, fingers crossed for you. We just need to be safe, not sorry. Please, social distance, especially when you're out shopping. Kids, I know you're locked in there as well. Don't know what you're up to, what games you're playing, because that's probably all you can do is either playing games, watching telly, if you're not allowed out. But I'm talking about lockdown here. When I'm driving out, it seems to be that everyone is out. And we were talking about football being cancelled anyway, because the snow, the grass would be waterlogged. If you've got football on the pitches, it'd be off after Christmas anyway, so you have to get used to it. The only difference is, as I say, we're all in lockdown. You have to stay in. And if we all abide by that, we'll all be out quicker than expected. So please do it. Let's know. Get in touch with us. Mal@don'ttextthelion.com. Send me an email. I just hope that you're all getting on very, very well indeed. And you're not too poorly if you've been struck down with a bit of a sickness. It is flu season as well. I'm watching loads on Netflix. And do you know what? I think I've caught up with everything. It's starting to get boring now. I'm starting to find something that I don't really like. Can you give me any ideas, anything that's up to date that you watched? I've watched quite a bit now. I don't know what to watch. Any horror films out there that really are edge of seat stuff? I like me horror films, see. And we can talk about that, I'll let you know. I'll watch one tonight. I don't think there's much on evening. Well, this evening, I don't really think so. The movies, Sky movies, you feel like everything's repeat. But what can we do? You can do jigsaws, you can do crosswords, you can have fun, you can play games, Monopoly, that goes on for hours. How many of you are starting to throw your board games all over the house anyway? Get the cop on because you've lost. So losers, we see plenty of them in grassroots football, don't we? Yes, we do. On the touchlines, shouting and screaming at the referee, blaming the referee for everything that goes wrong. Well, there's not much that can go wrong at the moment, is there, because we haven't got any games. But when you do have your games, remember the respect. Remember, let's keep our referees within the games if they do turn up. How many are contemplating on leaving the game? I'd love to hear from yourselves as well. Coaches, have you had enough, or are you going to push forward and keep your team in motion? Keep them playing. Kids, just bear with your managers, your coaches. You will get games in. Don't fold if you can help it. There's no cost at the moment, so why fold? I don't know what the leagues are going to be charging when you do start up again, which is in March. If they do go ahead, is it going to be carried forward to next season? Not too sure. Hubs, I feel sorry for them. They have to close the gyms. There's no football being played there. How's everyone getting on? Are we worried about Hubs closing as well? We didn't expect this for grassroots, did we? Not at all. Anyway, we're all on your side. Whatever decision you make, we'll all have to stand by it. And if there's new teams needed next season, I'm sure there'll be doors opening left, right and centre in the leagues. We don't think there'll be any summer leagues either. If there is, well, good luck to you. That's where loads of teams will want to be playing. And the grounds will get very, very hard, so you'll be able to use your new boots and not pull the studs out. Oh dear me, that could happen. Make sure they're all screwed in. If they're mouldies, you're all right. You have nothing to worry about. So good luck to each and every one of you who are playing the game, if you are playing the game. And if it's not, and you're all playing Sabutio at home, good luck to you. No cheating. What are you doing at home to pass the time away? I know there's plenty of you still out there working. I'll be working this week at grassroots football. In my job, support worker. Looking forward to seeing my service user. Been a couple of days, been off, but I'll be back. Up and running, back in Warrington. Now the floods have gone. Wow, I'm glad the floods have gone, be honest. I'm over the moon on that one. Anyway, we're coming into the last minute of our show. Hope you enjoyed the show. Don't forget, send me an email, mal@don'ttextthelion.com. Add me as a friend on Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, all the social network sites. If you've got anything to talk about, let me know what you're doing. Let me know if your team's going to fold. Let me know as a referee if you're going to fold or thinking of just packing it in and handing your whistle to someone else. If you can find your whistle, that is. Because I'm guaranteeing there'll be many whistles short. I think I'll buy a big load in because you'll all be shorter and you won't be able to find them for next season. Anyone got any Fox 40 whistles? I've lost mine, I've mislaid it. Good luck to you if you're a referee. Let's know what you're doing. Committees, how many committee members are going to be walking away just saying, not for me anymore, I've had enough. I hope none of you. Hope grassroots football survives and I hope your team survives in the FA Cup. And especially Liverpool Football Club tomorrow. Big show tomorrow, lads. You can't be empty nets for five games in a row. Surely. Let's hit the net tomorrow. two or three times, eh? That'll do for us. Okay, thank you very much for joining into the Grassroots Show. I'm Mal Lee signing off. So for myself, Mal Lee, and all the team is the Respect Programme, Grassroots Football. Don't cross the line. We wish you a very good evening. Put your feet up, relax. If you've got it next year, have a glass of wine. If not, have a glass of water. If not, cup of tea. And enjoy yourself. We'll see you tomorrow night at 7 p.m. God bless.